Dr. Philbert Nyeko, who was a director of Arua Regional Hospital by the time the hospital ambulance was stolen, faced the Public Accounts Committee and was questioned on the whereabouts of the ambulance, which went missing 2 years ago.
Talked of the key, movement of the key, but you've also talked of a spare key that was produced. Are you insinuating that the official key of the ambulance was still in its position with security, and it was a spare key, not known to you, that was a copy that was used for driving out the ambulance?
Sat still at the station, but the vehicle is gone. The fence is not broken, and nobody saw it going.
The ambulance was stolen from the parking lot, and that the matter was reported to the police by the health ministry, the hospital management, but 2 years later, it has not been recovered. Members of parliament are disappointed to learn that none of the security guards who were on duty that day were prosecuted.
Was there one at the back?
Yes.
We deploy classically three scaries.
Yes.
Two at the main gate. One is a backup behind. That is what we have. Then we also have a support from a security guard that helps to roll and give them reinforcement if they should need it.
Who of these three was arraigned for the anti-corruption court? Was it the one who was at the back, or was it one of the two at the main entrance or exit?
None of those.
After 2 years of investigation, I think the local investigation mechanisms have failed. Would it be prudent for us to suggest, just to keep tabs with this thing, that our CIDs also start participating in this?
Park committee members were quick to accuse the former hospital director, Nyeko, for covering up the staff who masterminded the theft of the hospital ambulance, which costed the government over 600 million shillings.
Even after 2 years, they are a suspect with insufficient information.
Before you came in...
Now they lift out the criminals and now they... So they could be...
Former director of Arua Regional Referral Hospital, Dr. Philbert Nyeko, who was the director of that hospital by the time the ambulance was stolen, is just covering the staff who orchestrated the stealing of the ambulance.
It was reported that the hospital driver, security guard, dental assistant, and other suspects were arrested, and the matter is currently before the anti-corruption court. Committee chairperson Medad Lubega Segona directed the Ministry of Health permanent secretary to liaise with the police and furnish the committee with the latest information about the matter. However, the committee was concerned to discover that the ministry did not ensure its fleet, which is exposing government to laws.
The police and government have on regarding insurance of vehicles, start to see if there was any violation or no violation. Because of this,
how much money has been put into tracking this one?
How many ambulances have you had stolen?
The one which has been stolen today, how much money has been spent on investigation, for instance? The investigators, how much money have they spent?
The Ministry of Health Permanent Secretary, Dr. Dana Twine, has informed the committee that ensuring its fleet is too expensive for the government to afford, but assured members of parliament that they will adopt a vehicle tracking which is yielding results. However, the committee tasked the Ministry of Health to budget for insurance.
The process of tracking started because we realized there's still a lot of misuse of our vehicles, and also when it comes to use of fuel, like for example ambulances, it was so difficult for us to know that how this fuel we give them, how efficiently it's used. But so the process started.
But someone make provision. How do they pay?
Just get a point. Make provision for insurance. Bring it here. If we fail to provide the money, that will not be your problem. Unless you tell us that there is a policy or law that bans.
Report by Fred Kajewi for the news.